history. When you are a colony, you are not as wealthy as the territory you are in.
Ooh,
you are as wealthy as the territory you are from. So here we have recession going on in America, high gas prices, people losing their houses, unemployment, and God is saying, look, I brought this program into your life to tell you, number one, you are not under the American economy. If you are a kingdom citizen, you are under heaven's economy. Number two, the government of your local territory cannot help you right now. So you need to put your allegiance to the government above that government, which is the kingdom of heaven. And this is why in the middle of a recession, you can still write a check to Benny Hinn's ministry, because you are not as rich as where you are. You are as rich as where you come from.
Whoa.
That's why the Bible says he shall supply all of your needs
according to his riches in glory.
According to his riches where? In his country. You are not as rich as where you live right
now.
You are a colonized citizen. You are as wealthy as from where you came. So that's why we don't fear what's going on around us. Matter of fact, in a kingdom, the government takes care of its citizens. This is why when you study the Old Testament, which I think is a great place to learn about kingdoms.
Sure.
God told him, he says, look, God says, a famine is coming to Egypt. Watch God now. He said, but Moses, don't worry. Tell the children of Israel that when the locust comes, what is a famine? Famine is economic crisis.
Yep.
He says, when the locust comes, I've already told the locust not to eat the crop of the Israelites.
In Goshen.
Now, how can a grasshopper know different between your corn and my corn? Because under a kingdom government, 1,000 may fall at your left and 10,000 may fall at your right, but you are preserved by the country.
Thank you, Jesus.
And therefore, I say to you today, your support of this ministry is not contingent on what happens in this country or in New York or in London. You are under a country that has a stable government. A stable economy.
I think some people are just having a praise break right now. I can just feel it, brother, because I want to have a praise break.
This is incredible. So, how do we colonize?
The key to colonization is the governor. Every kingdom, you know, Pilate was the most powerful person in that whole region, because Pilate was sent from Rome as governor to live among the people, and he was supposed to transform those people into Roman citizens. The Holy Spirit is the most important person on earth, because he's been sent here to live among us, in us, and he colonized us by, first of all, changing our language, changing our history, changing our attitude, changing our mentality. And I told you earlier, the Holy Spirit brings two things. He brings the fruit of the Spirit, which is the culture of the kingdom, and he brings the power of God, which is the transforming nature.
Now listen, before we go there, because this is awesome stuff, he was telling me this before we taped. Go back to the idea of the 300 that Rome sent and how that applies to the church here. This is amazing. This is awesome. So they would send 300 people to colonize.
Right. And once the 300 people from Rome was in a place, the king knew that place would become like
Rome. And so the church.
The church is supposed to be placed in every city in the world, every area. That's why God put you in business. He put you in economics. He put you in sports. He put you in media. God places people everywhere, because wherever we are, the kingdom is, and we are yeast. And so the Romans knew, if I could create a colony of people in a place, then the whole place would be colonized. And the king would send the governor to live among those people to make sure that all the culture of the kingdom invades.
Okay, now, before we get to the governor, I really want to talk about this, but we will go on tomorrow too, believe me.
We are like yeast.
Yes.
We begin to invade.
Absolutely.
Slowly and quietly.
You know, you're getting me excited.
See, you got me excited.
I can read this for you from the Bible. The Bible, Jesus said, the kingdom of heaven is like yeast.
Yep, it is.
That won't put in dough. Now, let me give you five things about yeast very quick. Number one, yeast always seem like it's insignificant. You ever seen yeast? It's a little like a grain of sand.
Yeah.
Number two, yeast is never intimidated by the size of the dough. Number three, yeast works quietly.
I love that.
Number four, yeast never becomes dough. Dough becomes yeast. And number five, yeast grows under heat and pressure.
Oh,
Say that again. This is awesome. It grows under heat and pressure.
Christ says the kingdom of heaven is like yeast. That means
therefore, when persecution, I gotta stand up. I'm sorry. You are getting me going now. So when persecution hits,
we expand.
My God. Wow.
That's why the church is not afraid of persecution, because it's like yeast. The more heat you put on yeast, the more it
grows. Lord, we praise you.
So whatever you're going through right now,
we praise
it's going
you,
to expand
Jesus.
Your territory. It's going to expand your influence. Oh. Peter says, when you face fiery trials, welcome them as friends. Why? They came to purify you so that you will be not found wanting. That means you'll be so effective, there'll be no weaknesses in your influence.
I'm amazed that my cameraman and floor director are this quiet today. They're probably shouting and clapping. This is awesome.
So the kingdom of heaven is the most powerful force on earth. And it is the answer to all the world's problems. It is God's original big idea.
Okay, now the governor comes and
the Holy Spirit is the governor. And the first thing a governor takes over when he colonizes is your tongue. You know, when we were colonized 200 years ago in the Bahamas, when that white man came from England, he made us stop speaking African languages. Why? Because the most powerful thing for unity in a country is language.
That is.
If you want to destroy a country, just multiply the languages. You remember Genesis chapter 11?
Sure.
And they had the first city built?
Sure.
How did God destroy the city? He didn't attack the city with weapons.
He just gave them different
languages. He just destroyed
languages. Yeah.
Well, that's why even America got to be careful. When you start talking about accommodating different languages, you are diluting the power of a country.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. America's got to be careful, you said.
I rest my case. So every country's unity is based on language. This is why the way God destroyed...
That is awesome.
The way God destroyed the Tower of Babel project was destroy the languages. The way God restored humanity on a day of Pentecost.
So now listen, you also said something else, and we're almost out of time again. Two things required: power and culture.
Yes, power is required in order for you to bring about colonization. And there must be culture. See.
And so this is where we get the power of the Holy Spirit and the gifts of the Holy Spirit.
If you study the fruit of the Holy Spirit, these are literally cultural.
Because like love, as you said
joy,
to me earlier.
Peace, long-suffering,
that has nothing
patience,
to do with power.
Kindness, goodness.
This is
this
all
is
culture.
The lifestyle of the people we're supposed to be.
That's
the culture of heaven. Heaven is full of love, joy, peace, long-suffering, patience, goodness, kindness. These are the culture. We're supposed to love everybody. We're supposed to be kind to everybody. Why? Not as a as religious practice, but as the culture of
listen,
our
listen,
kingdom.
Did you hear what he said? He said that we need the culture. So love, joy, peace, long-suffering, patience. That's the culture of heaven.
Yes.
And the power.
Then the power is the gifts of the Holy Spirit. See, we're supposed to love people and then have the power to remove disease from them.
Okay, we got to stop. We're going to go on tomorrow and talk about the governor. And he's just blowing me. I'm sorry. I got to just lay my hands on my head right now because it's just too much.
Hallelujah.
You are amazing. Are you enjoying this? Of course you are. Make sure to call your friends and tell them tomorrow, be watching again. God's big idea. It's all in this book. Reclaiming God's original purpose for your life.